Welcome to Daily Armor. Our verse today will be found in the book of Acts, chapter number 15, and we'll be looking at verse number 21. The book of Acts, chapter 15, and verse 21, and it says, "For Moses of old time hath in every city them that preach him, being read in the synagogues every Sabbath day." I just was thinking about what they've done every Sabbath day, year after year after year, and what is being preached in the synagogues is him. Who is him? The Messiah, Jesus. That's who he is. That's who they preach about. And they would go from Moses and the prophets, and he's everywhere. He's throughout the scriptures. And then I was thinking about what we do every Sunday is somebody, a man of God, preaches Jesus every Sunday, still preaching him year after year after year after year, and it doesn't get old. It's been going on since old times, but it doesn't get old. It's still the same message. It's still our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I was thinking about how that when Jesus preached, he preached to the people and he taught them so many things. And then he was crucified, and then he was no longer in the grave. He had rose from the grave, and he was preaching to a couple of disciples that were on the road to Emmaus. And he started expounding unto them. He started preaching to them from starting with Moses and the prophets about himself. So even Jesus preached Jesus, and he did it in the Old Testament. He did it starting at Moses and the prophets. And we know about that in Luke chapter 24, and I believe it's verse 27. Let me check and see if I'm right. Luke chapter 24. Let me turn there. Chapter 24 and verse 27, I believe. Verse 27, "And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself." Jesus preached Jesus. What did they do in the synagogue on the Sabbath day? They preached him. They preached Jesus. What do we do Sunday after Sunday after Sunday? The man of God preaches Jesus. They preach him. And it's doesn't get old. And it's wonderful. And I was listening to a song on the radio this week, and I remember listening to it when we were not able to open up the church for a little while. We had the church closed for a spell, and the pastor was preaching and I was recording it and doing it with our phone, and he still wanted the message to go out, and we were kind of figuring it out, learning it. And all he wanted to do was go to church. All he wanted to do was be back at church. And we recorded at church because it wasn't the same thing for him to record from home. It wasn't the same for him to be out in his building or somewhere or in a room. He wanted to be at church. He wanted to be here. And nobody was even in the building, but he still preached him. And he was doing it like they were doing it in the synagogues. He was doing it in the church. That's what we do. We come to church. And what a purpose there is to come here. What a purpose that we have to be here and to learn more and more about him, and for the Holy Spirit to be speaking to our heart. For you put the message, the word that the man of God has from the Lord himself, gives him the scripture and guides him with the way that he prepares him and studies, and the way that he brings it out of the man of God and delivers it to us. And it's so personal. There's so many times when I can be reading something, and I'm married to the pastor. I'm married to my pastor, and he doesn't know what I'm studying about a lot of times. Most of the time, he doesn't know what I'm reading or studying. Every once in a while, he did ask me last night, what I had been reading about and what I was pondering on, and I was just kind of pondering. I was going through verses talking about the Sabbath, and then today, this morning, I come to church and I'm still kind of pondering on those things, and then I read this one and I'm like, Lord, I know this is the one that we need for today, that every Sunday we do just like they did every Sabbath in the synagogues, that every Sunday we get to come to church, and we are so blessed to still get to come to church every Sunday and to hear Jesus preached. And I'm just so excited, and I hope you are. I hope that you look forward to, if you're not able to come physically to church, I know that, you know, that you, when we're not having technical difficulties with the broadcast, that we get to watch from home, but there's something even more special about when we get to come to church. So I'm so looking forward to the day when we all get to come to church without worry about restrictions and about worrying about the virus and all of the dangers that are out there, but when we can just freely again be at church and just continue to learn about Him. And I'm so thankful that we have the opportunity to broadcast live and be able to share that with so many others. And it has broadened the message, is getting out even further than just for those that were coming to church. So before, you know, the pastor was preaching to, say, 100 people or 120 people. I never even keep up with how many shows up at church. But say that he was preaching to 120 people every Sunday, and now every Sunday he gets to preach to 200 or 300 people or however many it is, and we don't even know how far it goes. But God does. And that's why we don't even really pay attention much to the numbers, but we know he's using it in a big and mighty way. And I just pray that you have a desire to be in church, and that we're not using all this for an excuse not to go, but we are looking in for that opportunity to get to go again, to get to freely get to go again. And I'm just so happy and so thankful that I get to be here, and I wanted to do my devotion today here at church, just having the cross and the pulpit in the background, and just how thankful that I am that I'm married to the pastor. I'm so, so thankful and so grateful that I'm married to the pastor, so I get to come to church and be here and hear him preach Jesus to my heart. And the Lord uses it in a big and mighty way, not just so we can keep it in, but Lord, so we can go back out and share it. So I just encourage us to, when we hear the man of God preach Jesus, take that and share it. Take it and apply it to our lives. And that's what I'm trying to do. I just try to apply it. And there's a lot of things that I have questions about, but those things that I do understand, that's what I just try to apply to my life. And I hope that you are trying to apply those things to your life. So thank you for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you at church soon.